How to survive the storm with a sailboat? Well, that's something that is not so widely spoken as well. Even though there is some few good videos that I found and some books, still it's not so widely talked. But here the information that I gathered, and here you have some tips. So let's go. In the storm, there is no perfect way how to do the things. Everyone has kind of different opinion of how, what is safe and what is not. But there is some things that you can avoid that can lead you to the potential problems. First thing that I want to say that is the sailboat deck area. The thing is that so many people store the things on the deck. For example, dinghy, fuel tanks, pedal boards, solar panels, and you name it. The problem is when the winds get strong, they can easily break most of the things that you have on the deck area that's not supposed to be there. And you might say, oh no, I secure with the ropes and stuff. Ask yourself if the boat gets flipped around. In extreme situations, suddenly everything is on the way. And the lines get ripped around, and all the stuff that does not belong to the deck becomes an obstacle for you. I know that most of the people store the dinghy on the front, and I do that too. And but when I do that, I check the weather, and I don't do that for the long passages. I just do that for 1-2 day passages where I can predict the weather. If there is a longer passage, I store the dinghy inside somewhere, make the deck area as clean as possible. And if you are in the anchor, make sure that you are not close to the rocks. Everyone knows that, I guess. When it's really strong winds, you really don't want to be close to the rocks. There are some tips for you. Check the wind direction, and if it's possible, park your boat against the wind towards the land with the front. If you have a bad luck, and if you did something wrong, and if the boat start drifting, you lift the anchor up, and instead of you being pushed to the land, to the rocks, you're gonna get pushed away from the land. So you have some options to do, because when it's strong winds, your engine might be not enough to go against the winds, and maybe you are not able to sail as well. So I think that's a quite good tip. Try not to panic and focus and be calm, because you are a skipper. There's a lot to say about the storm tactics, but the thing is that there is a lot of good books that I can recommend you, and I place the link below, and also the videos where people talking just about that for hours. I heard many people are hiding inside in the boat when it's storm. They kind of hope for best. I believe you have to be outside controlling the situation as much as you can. Take your time, plan the trip and possible outcomes. Here's some tips when you're sailing with the crew. So the crew are prepared. I want to mention one really important thing. Imagine you invite people and you go out sailing, and now you need to dock the boat. And you start screaming and yelling, grab the rope, not that one, that one. Oh no, no, not that one, you take that one. And it's a mess. So people get frustrating and people get angry because they don't understand what you want. And for you, it's like, why you don't understand? It's so clear. But from my experience, even me knowing quite a lot about that, when I get sailing with other people who are also skippers and I'm not skipper on the boat, I get confused. Many times it happened with me because they think different, and perhaps the people being there for first time ever, and so they're not gonna get a good experience. I promise you that. So to avoid a conflict like this, you as a skipper have to explain everything, and maybe not everything. And remember, don't say much, just the things that they need to remember where you need help. And don't expect too much from them, because you're a skipper. Even if they fail to do something that you ask, you are a skipper and you take responsibility of that. And that's not their fault. I always find a funny way I have to explain that comes to the docking and the safety, because it makes a little bit more fun. pretty much before I go out somewhere. I hope this was useful for you. Go subscribe and see you in the next video. For now, bye guys!